We can proudly say, welcome to Bolt 2024. My name is Emily, and I'm a junior here at Skyview.
And my name is Jennifer, and I am a senior, and we are so excited that you guys are here to join us in celebrating all of our amazing performers today.
But before we get into that, Jennifer, what is Bolt, and why are we here?
Yeah, Emily, about that, I actually don't know what Bolt is. Jennifer,
we have been working on this since October, and you don't know what Bolt is?
I just figured that you would explain it.
Okay, whatever, fine. Let's start over. You ask me the question this time.
Okay. So, Emily, what is Bolt, and, well, why are we here today?
Well, Jennifer, Bolt stands for Building Our Legacy Together, and it is a TED Talk meets talent show performance that Skyview puts on for the community every year. It is a place where we can highlight what makes each other unique and bring us all together.
Oh yeah, I remember now. But Emily, you kind of forgot to tell them about the most important part, our theme this year.
Well, since you forgot the last thing, I was thinking you could tell them.
Fine, I'll do it. Skyview, our theme for Bolt 2024 is Turn the Page.
Yes, Jennifer, but why is it Turn the Page?
Well, our leadership class chose Turn the Page because we wanted to focus on our performers' stories and highlight their past, present, and future. We want to turn the page to represent everyone in all chapters of our lives.
Yeah, that's actually pretty cool, but I don't think I can wait any longer, so we should probably introduce our first performer.
Yeah, we probably should.
So Skyview, without further ado, please give a huge warm welcome to our first performer, Tori Sharp!
Hello everybody. I'm Tori Sharp. I teach multilingual students here, so I'm an English language teacher. I'm also a soccer coach and a wrestling coach for those of you who I have not met. So I have been here a part of the legacy of Skyview since it opened in 1997 as one of 1,300 other freshmen. And so I've been able to see us grow and become something that we are today, and it's been really, really exciting. Before that point, I grew up in the area. I was a very young, self-aware kid. I recognized that I didn't have as much money as the people around me. I recognized that there weren't a lot of people that looked like me. And so I went home a lot of the times as a really little kid, kind of talking to my mom about, like, I don't know, like, everybody seems so different. And I was also lucky enough to have a very strong, independent woman as a mother who told me a lot of different things. But one of the things that she told me was, there will always be someone or something that tries to define you. Your circumstance, people, media, and even I am gonna try to write the story for you at some point. But you are the only one true writer, and only you know how you want the story to go. And so for me, that's something that I had taken really, really, really personally to my heart, and I decided very young that every single new page of my story would begin with a new adventure. I'm gonna try new things, I wanna define myself in new ways, and I wanna meet other people and other cultures in order to find out more about where I land in the world. This led me to go to college, to get my heart broken, to find the love of my life, and eventually to start this crazy new chapter where I moved to Japan and taught English, and I didn't know a single Japanese word when I got there. When I was in Japan, the most surprising thing that happened was that I fell in love with Polynesian culture. I met a really good group of women over there, and they encouraged me to try something new, which is this. I'd never danced in my life before that point. I felt very silly and stupid, and they were just so excited to share their culture with me and wanted me to be a part of what they loved so much. So today I'm gonna be dancing a very short dance to one of my favorite songs called Jungle. This song reminds me most of my time and my life abroad and gets me excited to add new chapters to my story and with new adventures to whatever pages that I get lucky enough to have in my story. And so when you watch today, if you're having a fun time, I'm gonna ask that you don't just smile or just like kind of clap. I'm gonna have you try a new sound if you're not Polynesian, but for those people who have Polynesian roots, how do you sound when you're showing something is exciting? All right, so for those of you who haven't done it before, I want you to try it. So it goes, you can also do this. So when I did it in Japan, it was like, I'll give that like a 2 out of 4. So let's try that again. And if you're kind of shy, but you want to do it, I just want you to go, Sue! Sue! All right, so please enjoy this dance.
Yeah.
Wow, Tori, that was awesome. But I don't know how she can do that without getting pretty tired.
I know, right? I don't get how people can be so athletic and good at things like dancing and sports.
Yeah, because it's not just challenging physically, but also mentally, which a lot of people might not know.
You know, I think I know someone who can share about an experience just like that.
Really? Who?
Skyview, please give a huge welcome to Cameron Watson.
Hey everyone, my name is Cameron Watson. For those of you who don't know me, I'm a freshman this year. I was nominated by a peer to talk about my story and my journey in athletics, which is something very much out of my comfort zone. This picture up here is the person people think I am. I decided to step way outside of my comfort zone to share my real story so people have a better understanding of who I am. I am more than just an athlete. This is me, and this is my story beyond the game. Being an athlete is more than just the glory on the field or on the court or on the track. It's a journey filled with sacrifices, opportunities, learning experiences, mental challenges, and often misconceptions. Here I am on my first day of practice for soccer. I think I'm 5 years old, and my first basketball practice at 6 years old in kindergarten. You can see that I'm smiling and confident and excited, but if only she knew the journey she would take between these photos and where I am today. Here is a video of how it started. Sometimes I'm confident in myself, and other times I get knocked down. Here I am making a lay-in, and here I am getting hit in the head by the ball.
Woo! Good job!
I've been very blessed and fortunate for all the opportunities I've had. Being guided by exceptional female coaches has made me who I am today. The picture on the left is Tina Ellardson. She was my soccer coach growing up for Salmon Creek. She pushed me to be the best I could be. The picture on the right is Angie Sun. She is my club Northwest Select director and coach. She provided me with the opportunity to travel across the country and compete against high-level teams. Both of these women have had an incredible impact on my life. Another opportunity is the Made Hoop Circuit, which exposed me to college coaches before I even entered high school. The picture on the left is when I played in Kentucky. There were 87 courts in this facility. It was massive. Playing for Portland Thorns Academy has pushed me out of my comfort zone, challenging me to compete against the best teams in the country. The right picture is when I was invited to play with the Thorns Academy against the U16's Women's Youth National Team. We also have the opportunity to practice and play at Providence Park for my soccer team. This is a picture of Nasir Little at Cameron Brink Camp. This is a picture of Sabrina Ionescu and Satu Sabali at University of Oregon. I went with my family to watch the Oregon versus U.S. Women's National Team game. Here's a picture of college coaches at the Under Armour Circuit. Kim Mulkey's in that picture. For those of you who don't know who she is, she's the LSU women's basketball coach. And here's a picture of Cameron Brink at her camp. I received an invitation to this Cameron Brink camp. Supported by my family, I've traveled all over the United States for my sports. Having the opportunity to play against different teams from all over has increased my knowledge of the game. Playing for two teams out of Oregon has helped me meet new people beyond my immediate community. This is a collage of the places I've been for sports: Ohio, Kentucky, California, Utah, Idaho, Arizona, Florida, Nevada, and Texas. Some of these pictures are from my basketball club when I played a year up and when I played at my grade level this last year. Other pictures are from when I played for my first club soccer team, Salmon Creek, and my current soccer team, Thorns Academy. I know I've been very fortunate for all these experiences. At a young age, I made sacrifices that set me on this path. While my peers celebrated birthdays, hung out on the weekends, and formed close friendships, I missed out because I was at a sporting event or practice. Saying no to my friends really hurt because I wanted to be a kid and hang out with them. I've been trying to gain those friendships back over these last couple of years. It has also been difficult for me to balance a normal teenage life. Trying to connect with people outside of school was hard because I was never around to hang out with them. These pictures are examples of times when I chose sports over time spent with friends. This is a video of me working on my ball handling during COVID so I could keep up my skills, and these are pictures of me during my games. However, the journey wasn't without its mental challenges. Growing up, I've always struggled with anxiety and self-doubt. My biggest fear is making a mistake or letting my teammates and coaches down. The picture is of me on the right is the picture is of me as a kid right before I got my tonsils and adenoids out. I was extremely scared and nervous. We thought my symptoms were a medical concern and the surgery would help. But this is the time when my family realized how intense my anxiety really is. And we've been working on strategies to support me. We work every day on strategies to support my anxiety, both at school and with my sports. I started seeing a sports psychologist to help me with my mental blocks and a professional physical therapist who taught me techniques to help prevent serious injuries by building strength in certain muscles. They both helped me see a different perspective on life and recognize the importance of self-care, both mentally and physically. One strategy is creating a pregame routine to help me with stress before games and take proper care of my body. For example, a few weeks ago, I went to Arizona for a soccer showcase. I realized my teammates can just wake up, get ready, and just run onto the field. I can't do that. Like, I have to wake up an hour before and I can have to get my pregame routine done. This helps calm me down before games and lower my anxiety. These pictures are examples of times when I had to overcome my injuries. The most challenging aspect is the misconception that surrounds me. What people see are the outcomes, but they never truly see what happens behind the scenes. The countless hours of training and the miles spent driving in the car to practices or games, flying all over the country, and the sacrifices made as a kid. All these pictures are what people see every day, which is why they think everything comes easy for me. But that's because they only see the outcome. My story today highlights that I'm more than just an athlete. In conclusion, my life extends beyond the game. It includes sacrifices, opportunities, mental resilience, and the challenge of breaking misconceptions. My family is my biggest support system. They help me get through my anxiety, and they are always there for me, even my little brother, who always makes me laugh when I'm feeling down. I hope you see not just an athlete, but somebody who has learned, grown, and thrived beyond the game. Thank you.
Wow, Cameron, that was great. It was really cool to hear about your experience with sports. What did you think, Jennifer?
Well, partner, I thought it was mighty fine.
Jennifer, what happened to you?
Well, what do you ever mean, Emily?
I mean the whole cowboy thing that's going on.
Oh, this old thing? I'm just excited about our next act.
What's our next act?
Well, our next performer will be singing some country and showing us what he dreams of doing.
People say I'm no good and crazy as a loon, 'cause I go to school in the morning and do sports in the afternoon. Kinda like my old blue tick hound, like to lay around in the shade. I ain't got no money, but I damn sure got it made, 'cause I ain't asking nobody for nothing if I can't get it on my own. If you don't like the way I'm living, why don't you leave this long-haired country boy alone? Preaching man talking on TV, putting down the rock and roll. He wants me to send a donation, 'cause he's worried about my soul. Jesus walked on the water, I still believe that's true. Well, I don't want much, nothing at all, but I will take another talk. But I ain't asking nobody for nothing if I can't get it on my own. If you don't like the way I'm living, why don't you lead this long hair? Country boy alone. Pick one on, boy. To marry while the rich girl wants to flirt. A rich man goes to college and us poor boys go to work. A drunkard wants another drink of wine and a politician wants to vote. Well, I don't want much nothing at all, but I will take another talk. And I ain't asking nobody for nothing if I can't get it on. If you don't like the way I'm living, why don't you leave this long-haired country boy alone? If you don't like the way I'm living, why don't you leave this long-haired country boy alone?
Well, that was awesome.
Yeah.
Jennifer, lose the accent. It's not even that good. Lose the hat while you're at it. Ugh, fine. Ruin my fun, Emily.
I don't think that was fun for anyone here.
Whatever, just introduce our next act.
I don't really want to anymore.
Well, I don't want to either. I'm not having fun anymore.
Well, you're being rude.
No, you are.
Oh my God, we're acting like children.
Yeah. I guess we kind of are.
You know, it reminds me when we were growing up.
Yeah, you know, it's weird. Maybe our next performer can share a bit about a past chapter just like that.
Yeah, you want to introduce her together?
Yeah, Emily, that'd be nice.
Please welcome to the stage, Kenna Leary.
According to the CDC, we're expected to live 78 years. That's 78 springs, summers, falls, and winters. That's over 28,000 days where we're expected to wake up and make decisions for the rest of our lives. As teenagers, we start to realize how fast time seems to be moving. One blink and we're turning 16, another and we're starting to walk across the stage of graduation, waving goodbye to our childhood as we hear our names called. As someone who's living it, that's all a bit terrifying. So I had a thought, the fear of growing up. The fear of changing and not being ready for said change. The fear of leaving behind the never-knowing mind of your childhood self. This is something that I found to be a common link between a majority of those around me. It doesn't matter where you are right now, you will always grow, they say. So why does it have to be so terrifying? I started to question how others felt about growing up, and I asked one simple question. What are your thoughts on growing up? I will share just a few quotes I received. Quote, as much as I may want to or possibly seem to be growing up, the truth is, it all happens without my knowledge, end quote. And, quote, I experienced nostalgia more. I find myself wishing I was young more, end quote. I got an alarming amount of feedback, but it all had the same underlying notion, the feeling of pain and heaviness, losing purpose, and slipping away from the people and things you once cared about. Think about how you felt about growing up, even if you found peace in it now. Did or do you feel the same? Look around you. How many others do you think feel the exact same way? Everyone is so stuck on moving forward that nobody is present. And that's what society has presented, the idea that growing up can't feel like you're actually going anywhere, like you're a stubborn houseplant that will wilt and revive itself 1,000 times over. Why can't the idea of growing up become the idea of growing yourself, a thriving plant in rich soil? All of these stories and anecdotes from people I've known for what is a small percent of my expected 78 years on Earth, their mixture of fear and hope deserve light just the same. And that's what makes the fear recede, the idea that I'm not the only one focusing on the uneasy parts of the future. One thing that was brought up the most when I was talking to people about growing up was the fact that many of them don't know how to put the feeling into words. It's an indescribable feeling, something that can only be explained through the experience. And that's why it's so important to talk about, because even though people find it so hard to put it into words, doesn't mean they don't have something to say. At 16, I focused on turning 17. At 17, I focused on turning 18. Now I'm 18 years old and I'm focusing on 19. I'm still the same girl that began working customer service freshly 16, who started thinking about a college and a career that would be fulfilling. Did I want to be a teacher, an interior decorator? Maybe I would follow in the footsteps of a parent. I was, and still am, so intentional about what life will bring, and it can get stressful. I spent a lot of the beginning of high school feeling unworthy and as if I was grabbing for each day to pass, and this created a monster of anxiety that focused so much on time that it passed with no joy or passion. I felt like an imposter among everybody who I was surrounded by, and I'm still working to overcome that today. I can now confidently say that those years spent will never be counted as wasted, because without them, I wouldn't have experienced the growth that got me here. I had no idea where I was going, and I'm still unsure about what I've chosen. What I know is that I have the opportunity to create and bend my future no matter what ends up working or not. I've learned that time is a gift. There's no reason to feel like it's wasted on growth. My passions came from endless trial and error. If you told freshman me what she was going to be doing her senior year, she'd shake her head. Change is scary, and it happens without any of us even knowing. While everything I'm doing now may not seem big, maybe they'll be the reason I find myself creating better things for myself in the future. And even though many of us are struggling and continue to struggle through it, it shouldn't be seen as a hopeless situation. Life will continue, whether you have to take a break, set a boundary, or follow a new path. Thank you.
Wow, that was really inspiring, Kenna.
Yeah, it's really crazy how fast life moves.
It is, isn't it? I've always thought it was awesome to hear about people's past, present, and futures, which is why I've enjoyed all of our performers so far.
Me too, and our next performer has a really cool story to share with us.
Really? Well, what is it?
Well, this person is a teacher here at Skyview, but that wasn't always his plan. He's always had a passion for music, and he's here to show us a different chapter of his life.
Skyview, please welcome Mr. Distad, a.k.a. Rude Boy.
Hey. What's up, Vibe Tribe? It's your boy, Rude Boy. That's what I say to my 3,400 followers and counting on social media. It's a familiar phrase to them, but it's also my brand. We chill and vibe in the Vibe Tribe, and we stay real. It's the heart of my message, and it's the reason that I make music. My music is what heals me. It's been there for me through difficult people and difficult situations in my life. And music has been my outlet for healing and overcoming. It's lyricism, rhyme schemes, alliterations, syllable matching, wordplay, entendres, poetry, storytelling, and capturing life's lessons and sharing them with others. Because I decide the thinking that I want to take, and I'm reminded of that decision and outlook every time I perform that song. And it's in line with who I am. It's in line with who I want to become and my character. And I found that's how you win in life. You stay real. You stay true to yourself. You stay who you are without apologizing or changing, and you inspire others to do the same. This next song you're about to hear was inspired when I was back and forth about buying my first beat back in October, when my favorite producer, Valentin, dropped a beat called Damian Lillard. Any Blazer fans in here? Yeah, any Lillard fans? I know we're 15th seed now and our season's over, but the very same day before, I was just talking to my father-in-law about how heartbroken yet happy we were for Blazers' longtime star, Damian Lillard. As I lay on the floor by my fireplace, all alone, the song flew out of me in about 20 minutes. When I was finished writing the song, I said, I have to buy this beat. So I bought both, the one I was considering and that one, and I got an artist to feature on the other one. And long story short, I now have 9 tracks recorded in the studio as a spring break. And my first single, as of today, I just dropped on all streaming platforms, Spotify, Apple Music. And it's the same day as my first, but not last, one of many performances as a rap artist. So, thank you. Thank you. So this song is written with a lot of passion for someone that I'm happy for, but it's bittersweet as we lost a valuable player. Hope you enjoy it.
Emily, what are you doing? We have a show to keep running.
I'm dreaming.
You're dreaming?
Yeah.
About what?
Well, I'm dreaming about something unique, something that's never been done before, you know? A performance that shows off someone's passion and love they've been doing their whole life.
And what's that?
Well, Jennifer, I don't know because you rudely interrupted me. Well, but I think our next act might be able to show us.
I think you're right. Skyview, please give a warm welcome to our final act,
Dream Manifestation.
Thank you.
Wow, that truly blew me away, guys. We are so thankful to all of you guys and all of our performers for being here today.
I feel truly honored.
And we are so grateful for all of our acts for showing us something about their past, present, and future.
Hopefully you all enjoyed the show as much as we did, but Jennifer, isn't there something we're forgetting?
Tonight at 6 p.m., there is an evening show in the auditorium.
Yeah, so everyone be there, and plus you'll get a free Bolt sticker.
So thank you, Skyview, for watching Bolt 2024, and please show up tonight at 6 in the auditorium.
One more round of applause!